During your lifetime, you have about 460 chances to get pregnant, and that's roughly how many menstrual cycles you can expect, with one egg maturing in one cycle. Or is it? What is certain is that the release of the mature egg happens so secretly. Let's see how exactly does this happen. No, much simple. There we go. Mood swings, lot of chocolate. The first day of your menstrual cycle is always when your period starts. This is when the egg begins to mature. Let's call this first phase for simplicity. Why is that your friend is so lucky that her period comes every 35 days, while yours comes every 28 days? This is because it varies how long it takes for the egg to mature in different women. So the length of the first phase varies completely. 1 or 1.5 day before your ovulation, the level of the hormone called LH increases in your blood. If you take an ovulation test, it will be positive at this time, as it detects high concentration of LH. And here's the twist. Your body doesn't know if the fertilization happened or the egg perished, so it prepares for the better scenario, which happens in the second phase of the cycle. If you are expecting a guest, you prepare a place for them, right? Your uterus does the same. The lining thickens to prepare for the potential newcomer. Your uterus is helped by a hormone called progesterone. Where does this hormone come from? You have probably seen this little flower that is often drawn in the ovary. It forms exactly in the place where the ovulated egg was released, and we call it the corpus luteum. It produces progesterone until it breaks down. Imagine that if fertilization occurs, this flower does not wither. Why not? Because the embryo sends it something. When it implants in your uterus, it starts producing hormone HCG, which pregnancy tests can detect. The HCG keeps the corpus luteum alive, which continues to produce progesterone, and your menstruation is skipped. If you are not pregnant, the corpus luteum shrivels up and progesterone levels drop because of this, and the thickened lining sheds in a form of bleeding, and you get your period. Your bleeding is normal if it lasts 3 to 6 days, gradually weakens, and red and odorless blood is released. Many don't know, but it's not normal if you experience brown discharge a few days before. If you notice anything unusual, please go to see a doctor. If you would like me to make a video about period problems, let me know in the comments. How can you predict your ovulation? You can try calendar method, but be careful. It's a misconception that ovulation happens on 40th day. The reality is that if you experience a bit more stress or sleep less, it can affect the second phase, which is called the luteal phase. It's not 14 days. It's vary between 12 and 16 days. So if you still want to calculate your ovulation, do this way. Observe the average length of your menstrual cycle. And now, subtract 14 from that number and you have the theoretical day of your ovulation. Once you calculate this, circle the date and also 2 days before and after, and seduce your partner on these days. If you want to be effective, observe your body's signals in addition to using the calendar method. In the next video, I will explain how can you read these signs. See you next time!